Dr. K. S. Ramakrishnan is working as an assistant professor, School of Education, Tamil Nadu Open University, Chennai 15. He has been teaching science education, environmental science, educational technology and research methodology in various colleges of education and Tamil Nadu Open University for the past 9 years. He has guided so many M.Ed., M.Phil. And Ph.D. students. His current research areas are environmental education, educational technology and media and communication. He has conducted various workshops on ICT usage in education, Wiki Educator, e-content development and educational research methodology. He had attended many online workshops on Moodle, learning analytics. He has published 6 books and many articles in national and international journals of repute. He regularly gives plenary and keynote speeches on environment and ICT related issues at various national and international conferences. He has delivered 28 episodes of the program Pudiyodor Ulagam at All India Radio, Chennai, related to various new developments in science and technology.
Welcome to UGC CEC program. In this episode, we will discuss about the wetland reclamation, and in this, the major contents, the wetland types, the major effects of wetland losses, the construction of wetlands, the restoration of wetlands, and the processes of wetland creation and the demerits of restoration. And now let us see what are the different types of wetlands. See, the wetland ecosystem, that is differentiated into so many categories. And they are the inland wetland ecosystem. It comprises of the freshwater marshes, the peatlands, the freshwater swamp, that is forested, riparian wetlands and open water. So, these are all the various types of wetland ecosystem and which are coming under the inland wetlands. And now, the next category, that is the coastal wetland ecosystem, and that is comprising of the tidal salt marshes, because the tide. So, whenever there are some gravity differences, differential between the earth and moon, the tides are created. That means at one time, the sea water comes into the mainland, and at another time, from the mainland, that water will go back to the sea, and therefore, these are called the tidal, and therefore, whenever the water is coming into the mainland, that will stay for some time, and therefore, that is coming under the tidal salt marshes. And the second, the tidal freshwater marshes, that means the only difference is here the salt water, that is the marine, and the second one, that is the fresh water, that is happening in terms of, that is in the case of the rivers. And the third one, mangrove. So, the mangrove wetland, that is another category. And now, let us see what are the restoration ecology. The restoration ecology may take many forms: restoration, enhancement, reclamation, recreation, rehabilitation, augmentation and translocation. That means, the restoration ecology that consists of so many different varieties. Reclamation is one such. Reclamation, rehabilitation, restoration, and all these are some different kinds of the rehabilitation ecosystem. And now, let us see the various differences between these categories. Rehabilitation, that is simply improving the degraded habitat, maybe not restoring it. That means, simply improving the habitat. Suppose, if a particular place, that is highly degrading. And so, in the terms of rehabilitation, what we do? We are simply improving the ecosystem of that particular area, and that means that we may not restore it. That means, simply we are changing the conditions of that particular ecosystem, and that means simply if we are able to sustain that is called rehabilitation. And the second one, reclamation. The reclamation may be stabilization of the land and or minimizing the further degradation. That means there is a difference between the first one and the second one. In the first one, we are not doing anything for the enhancement. Simply that we are, what to do, that we are rehabilitating. That means we stop the further degradation. That is called the rehabilitation. In the second one, you see, reclamation, we are stabilizing the land and or minimizing further degradation. That means we are stopping the further degradation. That is called reclamation. And today that we are going to say, discuss that only. And the third one, recreation. It is an attempt to return to historic condition, accuracy, etc. That means we go back to the past. So that is a very difficult process, but anyhow, sometimes we have to do the recreation also. And the next, replacement. It may recreate a site which may not be historically accurate. That means it may not be exactly what it was. And instead that we are replacing that with some similar ecosystem, that is called replacement. See, for example, in one particular ecosystem, a set of elements may be residing, a set of habitat, set of element, birds, animals, and some particular temperature zone, etc. And it may not be possible to restore back to the same condition, but what we are trying to do, we will create similar environment, and that is called replacement. That means instead of this ecosystem, that we are trying to do, or we are trying to create another ecosystem which is similar, equivalent to that one. And the next one, enhancement or augmentation, or attempting to add to the degraded condition but not fully functional. That means enhancing means that we are further going one step above. That means we are trying to enhance the degraded ecosystem. Augmenting means that we are adding something new also. And so in this method, we are attempting to add to the degraded condition but not fully functional. That means sometimes it may be functional, sometimes it may not be, because it is not possible to replace all those conditions which were prevalent in the historic time. And so anyhow, some elements may be functional and some may not be functional. That is called enhancement. And now, what are the major effects of wetland losses? So 50% loss of spawning grounds for fish. That means the spawning grounds for fish, that is lost 50%. And 50% loss of waterfowl habitat, and 50% loss of flood control capability, and 50% loss of erosion control and sediment trapping capability. That means because of the ecosystem loss, we are losing some 50% fish habitat, and the 50% the water element, that habitat, and that it is losing the flood control capability by 50%, and the soil erosion capability also it is losing. And therefore, in all ways that we are losing a lot of natural capabilities. So why so much wetland loss? See, there is a perception of wetland as wasteland or swamp. That is because of the ignorance. And the second one, economic incentives for development and urban sprawl. So there are two major causes. One is a perception. That means generally the people, they perceive that the wetland is wasteland. And the second one, for economic purpose also, most of the time it is somewhat easy to change the wetland into the human residences. And therefore, because of the two reasons, the wetlands are fastly losing out. And now, the major causes of wetland loss and degradation. What are the major causes? Biological alterations, the chemical alterations, and the physical destruction or degradation. biological alteration, that means we are altering the environment or ecology biologically or chemically or physically. So by all these ways that we are degrading the wetland ecosystem. And now let us see the biological alteration, that means the removal of wetland or riparian vegetation, that means the wetland is removed, and introduction of non-native exotic species. See, for example, in a particular habitat, particular ecosystem, some kinds of animals and bats may be living together, and there is an understanding between them also, because there is a food chain. Every animal or plant, they are depending on the other one. And in case if you are adding a new variety or new species, what will happen? There may be some mismatch between the habitat and the new species, and therefore that is as a result what will happen, the particular habitat or particular ecosystem that is lost. And so the biologically that we can alter by either removal of wetland or introducing some non-native exotic species. So these are all the two. See, for example, see the Rajasthan, once upon a time that it was a marine ecosystem, and at that time a lot of animals and other things, they were also there, and there was a thick forest was there. And when these Rome people, and they had hunted all the lions, so what will happen? So generally the other small animals like hare or that rabbits, and their population has increased, and they have cleared all the forest, the trees and bushes, and so that it has become a desert. That means when we are removing a particular animal or when we are introducing a particular animal, that particular habitat that is lost, that is biologically. See, the removal of riparian vegetation next to stream due to the residential development. See, that the particular water ecosystem that is converted into the residential places, and therefore here the residences are that they have been constructed, and therefore gradually what will happen, that water ecosystem that is contracting, and so in a long time it is totally lost. And this is the forming up to the edge of the stream. So here it's a stream, and here you see that is a till the edge that the forming has been happening, or that they are forming till the edge. So what is the net result? So because of the forming, this area of the water area that is gradually decreasing, and therefore in a long run what will happen, that is lost. And so these are some causes of the loss of water ecosystem or the wetland ecosystem. And here the livestock quarrel adjacent to stream, and when the livestock, they are also grazing or they are also using the wetland, so gradually that is lost. And introducing weeds and non-native plants to be controlled through biological, chemical and mechanical means are prevented by proper land management system. That means that is when we are introducing a weed or non-native plant, they have to be controlled, otherwise what will happen, they will grow that is without any control. In case if you are that is taking a new plant to a particular habitat or ecosystem, we have to control it either biologically or chemically or by physical means. So that means by all these means that we have to control. Uncontrolled growth of non-native plants, that will damage the particular ecosystem. So the chemical alteration, that is release of pollutants and toxic chemicals and the change in the nutrient levels. So these are all some chemical alterations. Now let us have a short break. Come back, let us start again. The release of pollutants and toxic chemicals and change in nutrient levels. So by that way that we can alter them chemically. And the water reuse, that means the reclamation of wetland provides an alternative water source for irrigation and for water treatment, and the riparian habitat for migratory birds, and the production of new problems. And so we can repair by so many other possibilities. And so now let us start discussing one by one. We can construct new wetlands. So before the, what are the various steps for construction? The survey, design and construction to restore water to an abandoned stream channel. That means how can we construct a wetland? So before that we have to survey which area or which place is suitable for wetland ecosystem, and then we first choose the place and we survey, and then we are thoroughly cleaning the place and we have to water it, and so gradually that particular land is converted into a wetland. That means survey, design and construction to restore water to an abandoned stream channel. And so this is one method for constructing of wetlands. And now the water management, see, draw down pipe for water management options on that area. That means once that we have selected the area, then we have to start watering it. So here you look at the diagram. So the pipes, they are constructed, and therefore through that water is spread into that particular area. And now we have to structure to hold water in the abandoned stream channel. That means we have to make some structure also, because okay, that you are watering it, but how can the land that is absorbing water, and for that we have to place some structure also so that they can hold the water, and then seeding and fencing, and the native grasses and flowering forbs, they are seeded, and fencing control the livestock, because once water is there, once we are seeding it, then naturally the plants or the herbs, they will start growing, and so that we have to secure it, and so that we have to fence it. So the seeding and fencing. See, now you look at the diagram. The once dry area, and that is gradually becoming a wetland. And now the hydrology, the surface water runoff from adjacent fields captured during the rain, and therefore the surface water also that is running off from adjacent fields, and so they are captured during the rain. That means this wetland, that is not a wasteland. So whenever the nearby fields the water is running off, that water will come to the wetland, and therefore all the minerals and the soil, they are captured by the wetland. And the animal habitats, so gradually the migrating birds, they will start using the area, that animals. And so what are the benefits? The improved water quality, the improved wildlife habitat, reduced flooding, the increased groundwater recharge, and the enhanced recreational opportunities and aesthetics. See, now you look at the diagram. See, once it was a wasteland, now it has become a wetland, and therefore now it is capturing the soil water, and the water is seeping into the soil, and therefore the water can be recharged also. And beyond all that, the migratory birds, most of the migratory birds, at least once in their life cycle, they have to come to a wetland for at least a reproduction, and therefore the migratory birds and animals, it's a good habitat for that. And beyond all that, it is a good entertainment, recreational area also. And so these are all some benefits of the wetlands. And now what are the steps in the restoration process? The site preparation, the hydrology restoration, and reintroduce plants and aftercare. And so these are all the steps in the restoration process. And first the site preparation. So the site is prepared, and the site the herbicide application. By applying the herbicide, all the weeds and all, they are cleared, and the controlled burn and the breaking the tiles, and therefore that particular area that is made suitable for the wetland. And then the seed collection and plant and the greenhouse production, and therefore artificially that we can create a wetland also, and therefore the seeds are collected and the greenhouse is produced. That means an artificial temperature zone or the particular temperature that is maintained, that is called the greenhouse production and the nursery production. So all these are some of the major steps in the restoration of the wetlands. And now the planting, the water on site, the dormant seed species and the plant sedges and forbs. So we are planting the wetland. That means, suppose in case if a wetland is available, now that we can plant also. And the weed management, a reed canary glass plant, that means a particular plant that is a weed, and therefore the weed should be managed. And then the spot treatment also, and a treated reed canary grass plant, and that means that we have to manage the weed also. See, actually the wetland means, in wetland there are some particular plants which are growing, and it is not meaning that they are all weeds, and therefore at any cost the weeds have to be cleared, and therefore by proper weed management we can clear all the weeds. There are some questions. Why that we have to create a wetland, and can it be done, and does a created wetland serve the same ecological purposes as a natural wetland? That means, is it necessary, why? And second, is it possible? And third, is it as equal as a natural wetland? So now let us see what are the answers for these questions. So our goal, the removal of contaminants from water, the toxic organics and metals, non-toxic nutrients and thermal pollution. So first of all, that we have to remove all the contaminant from water. That is our goal. And already that is the wetlands are naturally doing that, and therefore somehow that we have to do it. And now what are the uses? The municipal wastewater, the acid mine drainage, landfill leachate and non-point urban agricultural runoff. And therefore, these are the uses of the wetlands, and therefore we have to maintain the wetlands, otherwise that we are losing all these uses. And they are represented by the diagram. The municipal wastewater wetlands, the acid mine drainage and the agricultural runoff wetland, and the landfill leachate. That means these are all some various uses of wetland. The wetlands are not standing just idle, they are doing some ecological functions also. And so the types of treatment of wetlands, the natural wetlands they use for this often prohibited by laws created to protect them, the surface flow wetlands and subsurface flow wetlands. And these are the surface flow wetlands, and the second one, that is the surface flow constructed wetlands. That means we are creating a surface and we are allowing water, and that water that is staying here and the rest of the water that is going out, and this is called the surface flow constructed wetland. And the second one, that is subsurface flow constructed wetland. That means the difference between this one and the next one, it is on the subsurface. And what can be treated? The municipal wastewater, the agricultural wastewater and the industrial wastewater. So all these type of wastewater can be treated. And the contaminant removal mechanism, so there are so many mechanisms are there. Physical, so especially good for sedimentation, low velocity laminar flow and result in accumulation of solids and resuspended by wind driven turbulence, bioturbation, that means by humans or animals. So, by all these means that we can remove the contaminant physically. And now biologically and chemically, and now let us see biologically, the plant uptake the nutrients, nitrates, phosphates, ammonium, the toxics, bioremediation, that means the lead and cadmium, and these contaminants are re-releasing or accumulation in pits. So, by all this that we can remove the contamination biologically, and some other possibilities also by the microbial processes, the uptake contaminants in their biomass, the conversion by metabolic processes probably more important, and therefore, by all this means that we can remove the contaminants biologically. And now, the chemical process, adsorption and precipitation. Adsorption means, suppose when one particular particle that is joining the surface joining with the surface of another one, that is called adsorption. So, by adsorption or by precipitation. Precipitation means that sedimentation, that means at a particular, that is a down. So, that is called precipitation. So, by this chemical means that we can remove the contaminant. And now, let us see some demerits of restoration. Although the wetland restoration happens, only the hydrology is restored, little management occurs after initial construction, the natural colonization relied upon to repopulate plant community, and full complement of wetland types not restored. So, even though certain possibilities are there, it is not that we can fully restore the wetland totally, and these are only the hydrology is restored. And suppose once the wetland is created, the after management that may not be possible at all times, and the full complement of wetland types is not restored. And these are some more demerits, and they do not resemble the native wetlands, they do not exhibit the diversity of species nor complex structure, low diversity, planting density is too low, the lack of aftercare, and the plants placed inappropriately. And so, even though that we may try to replace or enhance the wetlands, it is not possible that it will go back to the original condition, and most of the time the biodiversity, it is very difficult to re-maintain the biodiversity because it is a natural process, and all the birds and animals and natural habitats and the natural parameters, they have to join together, and by artificial means it is not always possible. And now let us summarize. In this episode, we have discussed the wetland types, the major effects of wetland losses, the construction of wetlands, the restoration of wetlands, the processes of wetland creation, the demerits of restoration. That means, what are the various types of wetland, and how can we restore, what are the various possibilities of restoring the wetlands, and what are the demerits of restoration. All that we have discussed today, and now let us have some questions as well. The first question, define wetland reclamation, and second, write the steps involved in wetland restoration, and the third one, mention some uses of wetland restoration. The fourth one, narrate the major defects of wetland restoration. And the last, describe the physical, chemical and biological processes involved in wetland restoration. So, with that, let us conclude the session. Have a good day.